much of our attention today isn't even on any of that. Nope. It's on one of the best unrestricted free agents in NHL history, John Tavares, as we await some sort of word on where he'll sign. Sid, who do you think the favorite is at this juncture in time as he sits down the CAA offices, mm-hmm. the creative artist agency offices in Los Angeles? Who is the favorite to sign John Tavares?
East Coast kid, mm-hmm. wants to win. Mm-hmm. He's used to being able to walk into any mall he wants to, unimpeded.
Right.
Not a big deal when John Tavares goes to anywhere in the Long Island area.
Right.
Wants some privacy, potentially. Wants to get paid. I think he wants to get paid.
Yeah.
I wouldn't sleep on Tampa. I would not sleep on the Tampa Bay Lightning in this chase. No. And Steve Yzerman knows full well what he's doing when it comes to the rest of that roster. He'll make the moves he needs to make. He'll do what he needs to do to make this fit. Tampa's as in it as everyone else. If I'm the Leafs, you better pray this doesn't happen. You better pray he doesn't go to Boston. That's one angle of this that I think is very intriguing. The Leafs may overspend just to keep him away from that lot.
Right.
Which is a whole different thing. But if I'm a betting man, I'm leaning Tampa. It's got a lot of things he's already used to. They can pay him. They're close to winning a cup. You tell me John Tavares doesn't come close to putting him over the top?
Oh, without a doubt, yeah.
Man, it makes a lot of sense to me.
Yeah, I wondered if they were already the most talented team in the NHL. And I'll tell you one thing. I wouldn't put it past Steve Yzerman. Right? There were a lot of people talking about Steve Stamkos and what he was going to get in the open market and how much, right? And chatter at the end.
Just a lot of talk.
Sorry, what was it?
That's my too much talk.
Too much talk?
Sources indicate.
Right.
Yeah, it went home.
The one thing that I find interesting, and tell me if this would, listen, Toronto is in this mix for a reason, right? Like, Toronto is getting one of the sit-down presentations, yeah, apparently, with Tavares for a reason.
But it's one of the reasons, like, when you get married and you have that relative on your mom's side who's way closer to your mom than you, but you feel like you need to invite them. Like, out of respect for Toronto, are they getting...
Out of respect for his hometown.
Just out of respect for his hometown, so people can't chirp him that he didn't at least speak to. Not like Montreal, who he gave the Heisman to.
Right, like he wouldn't stop hearing it from his family because he's a Toronto boy if he didn't listen to the Toronto town. Like the cousins who end up coming to the wedding.
It's like, Ma, I don't want to invite them, but they've known us forever.
Right.
But I don't want to pay $100 a plate for these people. Like, it's one of those, right? Like...
Nah,
I don't know. Do you think he's seriously contemplating the Toronto Maple Leafs?
Yeah, I do.
Considering they're the only Canadian team in the rumor mixer.
I have said this for a long time. I do think that there is a part of John Tavares in our conversations with him that appreciates the idea of becoming a legend in Canada. Like, I think he understands. He's a very smart young man, right?
What?
Like, there's no, hey, this guy, he's just going to go for the life. Because the lifestyle, you're going to San Jose or you're going to Tampa.
Great internet in San Jose.
Yeah.
Terrific
internet in San Jose. They have wonderful Wi-Fi in San Jose. But if you want to leave a mark, if you win in the Toronto market, the rest of your life, you are set. You don't have to do anything. If he ends up being the piece that puts them over the top, and the one thing that I thought, well, all of that luxury tax, I mean, all that tax that comes from Canadian government versus some of these places, like if Las Vegas gets into the mix, like Las Vegas has no tax, right? Versus what he would be paying in Canada. And then I heard the idea of perhaps paying him the max they can in the first year at over $15 million for the first year, and then when they got to pay Marner and when they got to pay Austin Matthews, they lower down the average annual value of the deal to something more palatable at, say, like a $7 million maxed out over the years. Now, that's a real interesting way. And you could put that all up front. You could give them basically a $15 million check right off the top and make it a signing bonus and then have the wink, wink, nudge, nudge for the rest of the deal. I thought if Kyle Dubas is doing, like, those are the type of things that you can put Johnny on the spot. Sorry, I saw it up there, and I thought maybe I should reference it. But you could put Johnny on the spot if you did something like that. But that's what it's going to take for Toronto to get something like John Tavares.
This Leafs meeting
with him. Another center, right?
That's another center, but
another big money center.
Let's remember the context of the Leafs pitching to people. First thing, this is Dubas' first round in his battle amongst other GMs, right?
Yeah.
He's the young kid in the ring. You're only going six rounds because it's not a title fight.
Right.
Feels like a title fight. This is Kyle Dubas is thinking, if I can pull this off, suck it, Lou.
Yeah.
Suck it, all the haters.
Yeah.
Suck it, all the Marlies haters.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Second thing with the Leafs, let's remember, and we've all talked to enough people, it doesn't feel like rumor anymore. The Steven Stamkos thing scared him off. When Stamkos sat down and saw the presentation from the Leafs, when he's walking in the room with flip-flops, mm-hmm. and he's got the president of Canadian Tire and everyone else sitting there, and he left that room and he said, no way. There's no way. I'm not doing this. I want to be able to go to a patio on a Wednesday night and drink mm-hmm. and enjoy myself on the night off.
But why isn't here's my one beef with that, and I understand that argument, but here's my one beef with that. Why doesn't anyone say that to the Yankees or the Red Sox?
Hockey, Canadian market, what? American market's not the same. It's not the same argument, man. I don't think it's the same argument.
You don't think that playing for the Yankees or the Red Sox or any other, the Boston Celtics or any the Los Angeles Lakers, you think Lonzo Ball walks around L.A. and nobody bugs him?
But
do you think he embraces the fact?
I think he specifically embraces, but not everyone's Lonzo Ball. You think everyone said yes to the Yankees in the history of that organization?
No, guys flamed out there and they overpaid.
But I think
a lot of people.
I think people have said no to the Yankees.
No, but there's a lot of people like Aaron Judge who stand there and go, I love this.
Right, but like, Aaron Judge didn't have a choice to be a Yankee initially.
This is unbelievable to be riding high in the biggest market ever.
Right.
Right? Like, the soccer players don't get to choose. Right? They just get paid and they go.
Yeah, so the high-level ones get to choose.
Right. Well, but you know what I'm saying. Ronaldo's not playing for Porto or Benfica.
That's beneath him.
Right?
He's
in Madrid.
Yeah, he's in Madrid.
Right? He's in Madrid where the government is going after his tax money.
$18 million.
Yeah.
I'm saying,
John Tavares might be that guy to embrace that. I went a long way.
I hear what you're saying. My only point is, did the Leafs, because it was on Shanahan's watch,
right?
Did the Leafs learn a lesson with how to pitch to a guy you really want with Stamkos? And are they going to change that? Will they divert, and instead of going all in and bringing a bunch of guys in suits, do they go softer with the approach? That's the only thing I'm wondering here. Things will leak out. We'll hear a few things here and there, everything.
Yeah.
But this Leafs angle with Tavares and how they pitch him
is
fascinating.